Consider the last person who considered the sidewalk below. Standing on the ledge, tired of the static on her frequency, the breeze brushing tears from her cheeks, blowing through straight blonde hair, lifting strands in the air like feather on the wind. Did she wake up feeling strange that day? Strange, like helium, like elastic, like a balloon floating in the sky. Maybe she remembered her ex-husband, the way he used to wake up strange sometimes, knock her around the room to catch his balance strange sometimes. Maybe she thought about the last doctor visit. What pills was it today? The pink one? The white one? Oval or round? Packets or bottle? She liked the way pills rushed and bumped as they slid out the plastic container, a chorus that grew fainter each passing day. She woke up strange, but why? Wasn't she getting married, going to Hawaii, a volcanic diamond erupting on her finger? Her daughter, high school bound, tall, leggy blonde, modeled makeup in mommy's mirror. What more could she want? The cigarettes. How she loved the cigarettes. As she considered the sidewalk below, was she smoking? Where did she put it out? On the rusted iron railing? On the paint, peeling, chipped? She woke up strange that day and climbed out onto the fire escape, smoking to cool the burning inside. As she considered the sidewalk, was it a pool? As the breeze carried her, lifted her straight blonde strands towards the sky, as the strange floated away like a balloon from her daughter's reach, heavy with peace in gravity's embrace, did the sidewalk shimmer like water? Hmm. That's five stories. And yeah, I'm trying to figure out this form. I'm trying to figure out the prose poem. I have a mentor who said, that's not a prose poem. And somebody said, oh, that's a good prose poem. So I'm not sure I figured it out. So I'm just playing with this idea still. But this is a little, yeah, barren woman. And in this poem, SP is Sylvia Plath. Barren woman. Chopping it up in the kitchen, fluorescent lights, Wednesday noon. I told her I'd drop down to 101. Stress and heartache. Best weight loss program around. Free, too. She looked me up and down, asked, you barren? I thought, barren? Wow, she's bold. Popping a question like that in the middle of the day, hardly know her, front of the coffee machine. Me? A child? And I thought about it for a while. And I felt proud that someone actually thought it possible for me to be in the practice, in the body, able to actually bear a child in my body. And I fantasized in that moment or three that I was. Bearing a gift, bearing fruit, persimmons or a basket of tangerines, bearing witness to my belly growing, while I, all these days, had been burying the dream of ever having a child. And in that split second, or three, that the universe was planting a seed in me, I did a double take in my brain, repeated the question, make sure I heard it right. Did you ask if I was bearing? And she said, no, I asked if you were barren. And with that one slant and inflection, I was drop-kicked out of this fantasy. The script flipped, planted back in reality to the coffee drip of the kitchen, back to the life she read so well. Barren? Really? Hadn't heard that term since I read the poem by S.P. And wasn't that 1962 or 63? How cold a consonant. How cruel a vowel can be. Do people still actually use that word? Hadn't it fallen out of fashion? Dropped right out of the dictionary? Sure wish it had. Sure wish. Thank you.